Welcome back. This is question three. A little bit different, but we're gonna start with the same steps of just rewriting. We're gonna rewrite the integral. Just do say f of x is equal to 9 to sine of x with the integrand, this time being the square root of 1 minus t squared dt. Gonna identify it. Here we go. It's the square root right here. And we're gonna apply fundamental theorem calculus by plugging this sine of x in. That's gonna spit us out. Let's just write it here. Square root of 1 minus sine squared of x. Which, if we remember our trig, this can be rewritten as absolute value of cosine of x. We have absolute values because we have the square root, so we have to make sure it's positive. That's why we have the absolute values there. Now we have to differentiate the upper limit of integration right up here, sine of x with respect to x. And so now let's take that derivative, d of x, sine of x. Let me rewrite that. Sine of x is simply cosine of x. And now we just multiply the derivative of the upper limit, which is this cosine of x, by the value of the integrand evaluated at the upper limit, which is this absolute value cosine of x. So that gives us f prime of x is equal absolute value of cosine of x times cosine of x. Let's box in our solution, and that is our final answer. A little bit different, pretty much the same thing.